This cell phone video went viral on social media Sunday morning. It's the scene at the PNP Custodial Center where people can be seen scrambling after the tower guard alerted of a hostage crisis.
Sir! Sir!
The two men were heard talking about a hostage crisis.
Hostage daw ata nila si Dilima. Hostage daw ata nila si Dilima.
Sino
na ito? Andun ata lahat sila sa ano, kay Dilima. Nakay Dilima sila eh.
During Monday's press briefing, PNP National Headquarters Camp Commander Colonel Mark Pespes says he was at his office at the Headquarters Support Service Sunday morning when he overheard the commotion over their two-way radio. Cops at the custodial center were assisted by the Special Action Force.
Sir, pasok tayo. Pero ano ah, dito, dito.
Teka lang, tinga. Antayin namin yung ano namin. Antayin namin, officer. Ilan ba ang hostage doon?
Tatlong yun eh. Mga daw yung ano eh. Nang hostage eh.
Anong gamit nila, baril?
Hindi namin ano, nagpaputok tower eh.
While the SAF officer was en route to inform his team leader, another cop on duty arrived holding on to a rifle. Colonel Pespes says he and an officer of SAF were already inside a custodial center around that time negotiating with hostage taker Feliciano Sulayaw. He says the lights were out inside the Lima's room, but they can see the former senator seated at a swivel chair and the hostage taker taking cover behind the Lima. Pespes says the hostage taker was demanding a helicopter, a Hummer, and media coverage that will take him home to Mindanao. The hostage taker also allegedly demanded drinking water, but he refused to drink a bottled water, fearing the drink may be laced with sleep-inducing substance.
Then nag-threaten na siya na by 7:30 papatayin na kita. So mabilis lang na decision. Tapos nung humingi na siya ng bottled water, ay ng tubig, gusto niya sa dispenser. So pumasok ako sa first room. And then pumasok ako sa may dispenser. Tapos so eto na po, sabi ko kay Sulayaw, ipinakita ko yung half body ko, tapos ibinigay ko yung tubig. Ayaw niyang abutin, then pag abutin niya, lalapit at lalapit sa akin. So ibinigay ko sa table, sa tabi. Tapos nung sinabi kong, Feliciano, malalaglag ito. So nag-attempt siya na hawakan yung baso. Nung nakita kong medyo na-expose na yung ibang katawan niya, doon ko na inilabas yung baril.
The hostage crisis ended when former Senator De Lima was rescued. The PNP says De Lima is now staying at the PNP General Hospital while her cell is being fixed. The PNP also reported that the cop on duty who was stabbed by the assailants is now in stable condition. Police officers who responded to the hostage crisis were honored at Monday's flag-raising ceremony. In an interview with the ABS-CBN News Channel, De Lima spokesperson Attorney Dino De Leon says the former senator may have been the target of the assailants.
I personally, I'm not speaking in behalf of the entire team, but I personally do not discount that possibility that it was the Senator Dino De Leon was specifically targeted. Takot na takot nga sila ng mga ordinary visitors like foreigners going to the to Senator Dino De Leon. Grabe yung security features. Yung pala makakapasok is somebody from the inside na supposedly guarded rin yung inmate na ito.
But PNP Chief General Rodolfo Azurin Jr. believes De Lima was not a target.
Nakausap ko naman po si Senator De Lima. Sabi nga niya, it has been her practice na between 5:30 to 6 o'clock, open na po yung kanyang pintuan because that's the time din na she conducts her regular exercise and morning ritual, specifically yung praying the rosary. So it was really an incidental or it's an incidental na yun ang natumbok niya, no, ni Sumayaw.
Azurin tasked the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group to conduct an investigation. The Chief of Custodial Center, Colonel Patrick Ramiliano, has been relieved as a matter of procedure for administrative investigation. The PNP now vowing to reevaluate existing policies and implement stricter measures inside Camp Crame. George Carino, ABS-CBN News.